Hello, this is John Emmanuel Pillai for the Noble Sage Art Gallery in London. And I'm with my up-and-coming, emergent, various, now quickly getting established artist, V. Anamika, who's standing right next to me. Thank you for talking to us today. Tell us a little bit about where you studied and your background.
I studied in College of Arts, Chennai. It's the one of the most first colleges to be in India to be started for fine arts. And there's an eminent artist called Mr. Dhanapal. I had an opportunity to do my personal course for 1 year. He taught me how to do the basic things before I entered into a professional art course. I had an interest to do some professional course as in art or in architecture. Then I landed in arts because I had more freedom to experiment with materials.
So shall we see your work?
Yeah.
So we're going to the studio. These are the kind of series of works that you started with about 3 years ago.
Yeah.
And that's kind of, I think you can see a kind of line of conceptual interest that takes you all the way to today.
Yeah.
In the works.
Yeah.
You can see your architectural roots in these as well. Where would these forms come from? That's a good question.
It has to be very new for me.
Right.
I never wanted it to be look alike.
Yeah.
It
has to surprise you.
It should be very surprising, the forms.
What's interesting, they remind me of the Bauhaus, you know, Bauhaus movement.
It's the
Bauhaus movement. It kind of reminds me of that, but with a little bit more excitement. So if we move these to a side and then we move on to your 3D works.
When I was doing those two-dimensional works on a canvas, at the time I had a thought, I had to give some the dimensions and the volume to the forms, especially a body to the forms. Then before doing this white and getting into fully white, I was experimenting with the construction of forms like this and applying different colors of layers and working on it. But I was not comfortable with it and it didn't have the feel, the colors and the depths were not felt very well when it had dimensions. And I landed up, just wanted to put white and see how it was. And it was very interesting that it had its own value just with the natural source of a light and the movement. When you go, just walk aside besides the work.
There's different movements in the piece. These kind of movements down here, and these subtle changes there. Do you notice them all? You notice them all. These lines. They remind me of Ben Nicholson and people like that, where you're playing with the shapes, with the forms, with the fall of light on it, with the textures, and with the internal shapes created, like an internal shape like that in there, or an internal shape like the shape that's left negative space here. So I think it's very interesting. I think unlike the ones before, these ones rely on light to
rely
play a
on
part.
Light.
Because the shadow there will be constantly changing, dependent. And when that changes, the rest of the work changes. They become very enigmatic. And from here, you took recently, jumping forward, a trip to London, didn't you?
Yeah.
And you did these works.
Actually, I went to London to study Japanese woodblock printing. And I was very confined to a very interesting and traditional technique. But still, my mind was searching for something which gave an artist some opportunity to feel the materials very directly. When I accidentally found out, when I was just packing some materials, just with the cello tape, and when I just happened to take it, remove the packing out, and the cello tape had picked up the images from a newspaper or a corrugate sheet, whatever. That was very interesting, and I wanted to imply that technique very professionally, and I applied the technique also with the high quality vinyl strips transferring the newspapers. And these are some prints which has been taken directly from a newspaper without more of technical influence other than just keeping it under the press and taking the impression out.
So there's two types of printmaking techniques.
Yeah, this is two types of printmaking. One with the sellotape, vinyl strip.
So that's a sellotape put across it and then ripped up nicely, neatly. So it creates a print of sorts. But if we move on from that, so the idea of transference was taken forward and we moved to a work like this.
As I said, it was at the time I had, it was a new experience for me staying in a new place and working. And I was finding the newspapers and the media more interesting, like it was so different news is coming at the time. And at the time I was more reading newspapers and more pamphlets or books, whatever I came across. Then I just wanted to use the technique which I learned or accidentally found out to apply to this newspaper and just took the surface. Because as the newspaper has two surfaces, one front and the back, it is a very sensitive plate that you just, put the high quality vinyl plate, sheet tape, and take only the surface and just stretch it on the hard wood.
So what Danamik is saying is that the newspaper sheet is actually two sheets put together.
Two sheets.
So when the sellotape or the vinyl tape is put on the actual newspaper, it can take one of those sheets and leaving the other one, making a transference rather than just a collage, I guess. Yeah. That's the difference. So it takes a transference which is organic, like you say, because it doesn't take everything, it takes some things. And then Animaker takes it and stretches it over this wooden board. And that's what you're seeing on top, but behind it is a mirror.
Yeah, behind it is a mirror. I just wanted to say that we are also a part of the society and the message what we are just reading from the surface of the newspaper.
So if we move from those to the works that are going to be in the exhibition, and these are continuing your transference idea.
Yeah.
So the here you said that there were just different kind of things like in your area in the ground that you would take your tape to and literally pick it up.
Yeah.
And make thing, and all these things lay very close to each other?
No, I had to travel because I was doing at least 2 hours travel, just walking and exploring the place. Wherever I found whichever materials I liked, I just put the sellotape and just take it very carefully and come to my studio without disturbing them.
This one, for example, you're taking whatever it is, or you're taking the whole thing? I mean, you're taking the first layer of...
Yes, the surface which could be transferred to my vinyl tape. In this work, what interested me most is the existence of many materials together. Even though they had a different character, different nature, different color, and the contrasting things existing together.
I think this is a subtle movement though. I mean, you can say that this is transfer, and it is a transfer. But the thing is, you've got full objects in the tape, so which don't leave something where you got it from.
Yeah.
So I mean, it's kind of becomes, it treads the line between transfer and collage of found objects, isn't it?
Yeah. Sometimes you can say that.
Mm.
But the process is the most interesting part of the work.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for talking to us, Animaker, about your work. Yeah. We've got a real feel for the for your work and how you've progressed. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
And look forward to having your work in these two works and three more in the coming She India show.
She
thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.